Hello again, here we will generate a QR code and then read that QR code. To be clear, this is not a scan. We will not be able to take photos of QR codes and scan it, for that is a little more complex. We will be able to take pictures of QR codes and read those pictures. To generate a QR code, we need to install Pi QR code, okay? And to use Pi QR code, we need to install also Pi PNG. For Pi QR code, we need to install pip install Pi PNG. Hit enter. Pi PNG was successfully installed. Now we can clear the screen and pip install Pi QR code. Hit enter. And Pi QR code was successfully installed. In the other hand, to read, we need to install Pi Zbar, and Pi Zbar requires us to install Pillow, okay? For Pi Zbar, first we need to install Pillow. So pip install Pillow, hit enter. Pillow was successfully installed. Let's clear the screen and now we can pip install Pi Zbar. Hit enter. And is just this. Now that we installed these, we can move on to the code part. So let's start by doing the generate QR code. For that, we need to import Pi QR code. Then we declare a QR that is equals to Pi QR code dot create, and we provide the string hello. Then QR dot PNG. We give a name for the file, abc.png, and we give a scale that is equals to, for example, 8. This is important. If the picture is too small, we will not be able to read it, okay? Generate the QR code is just 3 lines of code, okay? Now we can test this. Let me open this for us to see that the abc.png appears. Open the terminal and type Pi gen read QR code. Hit enter, a new file was created, this abc.png, and this is our QR code, okay? Now we can move on for the next part, that is the read QR code. Let's go a little down and from Pi Zbar dot Pi Zbar, we import the code. Also from pill, we import image. Now we can declare d that is equals to the code. We pass image.openabc.png. After this we can print, and now we can test this. We open the terminal and type pi gen read QR code, hit enter, and we got this, okay, where we have here the information, the hello. Let's make this a little pretty. We go here and we get the first element of the list and we get the data, and because this is a binary string dot decode into ASCII, we run this again and we got here the message hello. And this is the end. You can download the source code. The link is in the description. Don't forget that. Please give it a like if you find this video helpful. And as always, thank you for watching.